All right, let's get this workout going. We're going to be working everything from the hips down for the next 60 minutes. And like I said, I'll offer modifications throughout. 1-2 test. All right, guys, here we go. Let's just take it down with those squats. Take it down and up and down and up. That's it. So what I want you to do is push that butt way out behind you and put all the way back in those heels. Now, the whole time throughout the workout today, the abdominals are going to be contracted. Those muscles are working to support and stabilize the lower back. You want to keep that chest lifted and the airways open. Little deeper down. Now, as you come up, I want you to drive as hard as you can into the heels to power on up. Squeeze the butt at the top of that squat. All we're going to do, guys, is a hamstring curl. Looks like this. In. Ooh, 1-2. There we go. Drive it back. We're just going to add a little variation. Two singles and a double. Single, single, double. Single, single, double up. There you go, guys. Now you see I'm driving my arms back pretty powerfully. I need to get my heart rate up there. Because in a couple of minutes, we're going to be lifting that super heavy barbell. That's it. Got to make sure you're ready. Mind, body, and soul. One more time. From here, guys. Knees up. Knees up. Good job. Standing tall and proud. Bring that knee up as close to the shoulder as you can. We're going to reach across the body with a little tap. Go.
Five, four, three, two, one,
tribe. That's called a negative rep. So you keep it on your back if you like. The last one, you can either take it to a Romanian deadlift, or if you're more advanced, place it back on the shoulders. And again, like Romanian deadlift, the back is long and strong, and you take your time to find that maximum point of tension in the hamstring. And that's it, guys. Those are your three exercises, 30 seconds each. We do it three times to it though, okay? First one should be hard, second one harder, third one we're headed to fatigue, all right? I will give you an extra time after the first one, and you need to add weight. All right, guys, we're going into that back squat. Ready? Three in the lower range. Weight to the heel, sticking that butt behind you. Now drive as hard as you can into the heel drive. You don't have to stay with me, and you don't have to stay with the music. Woo! How low can you go? And then you want to limit that range of movement at the bottom. As you come up, guys, you want to squeeze that butt real tight. That's it. Woo! Yeah, yeah, yeah. One more time. Now you can either take it to a zercher, or you can stay like this. Zercher is advanced, guys. Take it into the elbows. Ready? Count down to five. Go. Five. Four, three, two, one, and power up. Take that time of attention. Now in this searcher position, guys, the bar is going to try and take over and pull you out of alignment. So you have got to focus, keeping all your weight back in those heels, keeping that chest up, and pull the abs in as tight as you can. Woo! Hold on up, guys. Now you can either do a Romanian deadlift, or if you're advanced, into a good morning. Shoulder blades together, either way, legs almost straight. Ready? Down for three. Two, three, and drive up. Look up through your chin. Either one, head is in alignment with the spine. You're driving the heels down to the floor. Little bend in the knees to activate the hamstring. Now just down to that maximum point of tension and then you pull out, right? One more, you guys. Woo! And come on up and safely clean and press. Nice start, I'm already sweating. We're like 2 minutes and 11 seconds in and I'm tripping. So you need to add more weight to the bar. Now is the time to do it, guys. All right. So you should be like me, breathless. Starting to glow, all right? So we're going to go back in and do the exact same thing again. All right, guys, think about our forward alignment and just making sure everybody's caught up. Use the mirrors as your coach. So now this should be really hard, okay, guys? Once you're ready, we're going to safely clean and press that bar up on the meaty part of the upper back. Take your mid-stand squat, guys. Be just over hip distance. Get ready, lower range. Now go. Three, two, one, and then drive up as powerfully as you can. Now when you're down there, guys, can you wiggle the toes once in a while? And that will just make sure we are correctly aligned. Now you want to keep the elbows directly under the hands, and that will encourage you to keep that chest tall and proud. You want to keep the airways open. Keep driving through the heels. By driving hard into the heels, you will activate the glutes. One more time. Woo! And hold right there. You can either keep it on your back, guys, you will level up to that stretcher. Are you ready? Negative rep. Down for five. Let's go. In five, four, three, two, drive up. So you've got to overcome that inertia at the base of the movement. And power up. That's it, guys. So the bar, being as heavy as it is, and being anterior loaded, is going to keep pulling you forward. You've got to resist against that. So squeeze the shoulder blades together, keep driving through the heels, and pull the abs in. Super tight. muscles that you're contracting in order to lift that bar up. That's it, guys. Usually, maximum point of tension is just about mid-shin. That's it. So the hands should go tight, tighter, and at that tightest point, you come on out. Could you go heavier, or are you struggling to maintain that weight? I'm like, the lunge is hard for me because I'm sweating now, but I'm still going to try. One more round, guys, and we'll be moving on. Let's see what you got. Woo! Yeah, you can always substitute with dumbbells, no worries. Sailing lean and press. Mid-stand squat, lock on the abs, heels down. Lower range, three pulses. Let's go. One, two. And then drive up as powerfully as you can. If you can remember to do that little contraction of the glutes at the top of the movement to finish powerful and clean. You want to avoid falling onto the balls of the feet or rolling forward onto the knees. Everything is in those heels, like you're sitting back into an invisible chair. Keep it going, guys. Woo! You look amazing out there. Very nice form. Once again, I look like I've got a room full of trainers. In four, in three, in two. Good job, guys. All right, lurcher, or you can keep the bar on your back. Are you ready? Down for five. Five, four, three, two, and woo! As fatigue starts to set in, it's gonna be harder and harder to overcome that inertia at the base of the movement. So it should require even more power from you as you start to get fatigued. That's it. So think of a power thrust through the heels. That's it. A powerful upward thrust. Beautiful. Woo! And hold right there. Oh my gosh, you guys. Last time. Deadlift or level up, take your advance with that good morning. Ready, guys? Shoulders back, head up. Ready? Let's go. One, two. Now, this is very, very unique for every single individual in here. Everybody's at a different place on their journey, and everybody has a different amount of flexibility in those actions, right? So don't compete with anybody else. I want you to tune in. Where is maximum tension for you? Very nice. Woo! Looks good, you guys. Five, four, three, and hold right there. Beautifully executed. So if you clean and press. Woo! And drop down. Superset number 106. Done. Now the next one, you can do it with a barbell. But you're gonna feel off balance, so if you don't wanna do it with a barbell, you don't have to. I'm just gonna show you the modification with a dumbbell, but know that you can put the bar on your back. The first one is a deficit rear lunge. Foot's gonna go dead center, chest is up. Now again, we're working on a negative rep. You're going three, two, one, driving through that front heel that is on the floor, all right? We'll start off with 30 seconds on each side. The next one is a side lunge, 3, 2, 1, with a barbell or a super heavy dumbbell. Toe is forward, 1, 2, 3, rise only. I'm not doing a step in because if you've got a barbell and it's really heavy, I'm gonna keep you neutrally aligned and keep you grounded. Okay, guys, that's it. From now on, each superset, you've got two exercises. If that deficit is too much for you, do it all on the floor. 1, 2, 3. All right, guys? So I'm gonna turn the music up. You're only in for 30 seconds. All right, just 30 seconds. All right, let's go ahead. Safely clean and press. If you've got the bar, or pick up your dumbbell. If you're doing a deficit, one foot is dead center. Line up, square up, feet hip width apart. Ready? 5, 6, 7. 3, 2, woo!
You want to keep driving as hard as you can into that heel that is on the ground. You got it. Super. Woo. That's it, guys. Now, once you get your confidence, can you start to come just a bit lower? 5, 4, 3, 2, and hold. We're gonna do the other side in a minute, guys. We're gonna take it to a side lunge. Now, take the leg wide, toe is forward, just one side only. Ready, let's go. 3, 2. Now, it's really important that we don't lean over that knee, right? So what we wanna do instead is take that butt to the window behind you. Keep that chest up. Now, the more you push that back, that butt to the back window, the lower you're gonna come. Woo! You should be struggling to push back up to the midline. It should take all of your weight pushing into the heels and into that lateral edge of the foot. Lovely. And hold right there, guys, and carefully push back in. Oh my gosh, we're going on the other leg. 30 seconds, deficit, we're on the floor. All right, guys, make sure your feet are hip width apart. 5, 6, 7, 3, 2. Now, we're really unstable in this position, right? So we want to think about utilizing, stabilizing muscles to keep us correctly aligned and to keep us safe. So first of all, pull the abs in as hard as you can. Now lift the chest tall and proud. Squeeze the shoulder blades together to help encourage you to keep that body tall and strong. Keep driving as hard as you can into that heel that's on the ground, and that will keep you balanced. Once you've got it, start to increase. How about one more right here, guys? Woo, shake it. Hold right there. Beautiful. Everybody okay so far? We're on the other leg. Take it as wide as you can. Toe forward to prevent overloading the knee. Ready? Down for 3, 1, 2, 3. Second is a negative rep, right? Woo! Now, how low can you go without actually getting stuck down there, right? So even though we're sticking the butt way out behind us, that chest is up, we want to keep the airways open. How about a little deeper? So every single rep, you want to see if you can increase your personal best. That's it. We're going to keep pushing the envelope. One more. And hold right there. Woo! Now guys, we're going to give you a little break. We're going to go back in just one more round. But this time, 15 seconds on each leg for the deficit and the side, and then we're moving on. Are you okay with the weight you got? You got this? All right. You can always have a dumbbell. So guys, we're gonna take it back onto the bench. Only 15 seconds on each side. So I figure maybe that will give us 4 reps on each leg because we're working with that negative rep, right? All right, guys, center up. Ready? 5, 6, 7, 3, 2, in, drive. Just like we did in the squats earlier, you wanna think about a power thrust up. That's it. Oh, according to the timer, we can do one more. Down. And switch legs, guys. Take your time. We're going to go ahead and do 5 on the other leg. Are you ready? Let's go. 5. Drive on up. If you feel like you're on a tightrope, take that back foot a little bit wider. It's called a deficit lunge because we're getting a much bigger range of movement. One more, guys. Woo! And rise on up. Oh my gosh. Woo! All right, let's take it wide. This time, how about we go side to side for 30 seconds. Now, take it wide and walk the feet out a little wider. Ready? Let's go, guys. 3, 2, now to the other side. 3. Lovely. 3. That's it, so every single rep, it counts. We want to think about quality of movement and constantly using those mirrors to hold you accountable. So those mirrors become your coach, right? Just like a dancer, in a safe position. Good way to flex. Oh my gosh, guys. Good news. Woo! We're on superset number three. I am absolutely dripping up here. If you haven't got a Versa loop, you might want to grab one. Green is easier, purple is the hardest. All right, guys. Now, what we're going to do is a zigzag. If you want to make it really easy, you take the band 1 inch above the knee, all right? 1 inch above the knee. The higher it is, the easier it is. Harder is mid-calf. Super hard is the ankles. Insane is stand on the bit, on the band. All you're going to do, guys, is a bigger zigzag as you can. A zigzag, you step 45 degrees, traveling forward for four, and you want to take it wide every single time. So you're going to do that for 30 seconds. Now, the next one, I'm actually going to stand on one end of the band, and the other one is around my ankle. All right, guys, what I'm going to do, if I get myself right, is one stagger, one hip extension. All right, so if that doesn't feel good around the ankle, you can just stand on it. One stagger. But you see how much more limited that range of movement is, and this is with a green. Okay, so don't worry, guys, we'll get it. I'm just gonna take this off so that I can keep teaching. So what we're gonna do, zigzag, front and back. If you wanna make it harder, grab yourself a dumbbell. All right, guys. Come down low. 4, 3, 2, zigzag. Side, side. It doesn't matter whether you take 2 steps forward or 4 steps forward. It doesn't matter. Every single time though, we want to take it wider. And if you can handle it, come a little bit lower in that squat. That's it. So again, the core is engaged, the chest is lifted, and the head is up. Taking it as wide as you can. You want to feel it in the inner and outer sides, and it's gluteus, medius, and minimus. That's it, guys. In 5, 4, 3, 2, hold right there. Now, you might want to try standing on the band, or you can keep it around the ankle. One heel up, guys. You can also use a dumbbell. Ready? Now, we're going to take it down to a stagger. Let's practice one. Come down. Rise up, and then take that leg behind. Are you ready? Let's go, guys. All the way down, and as high as you can. So you don't even have to think about speed, but what we do want to think about is that tall, upright body. So as I do that hip extension, the toe is down, and that heel comes up. That's it, you guys. Squeeze. So you want to feel a tight contraction into the glutes. Looks good. As you do that stagger, you want to try and bring that butt all the way down to the heel. It's going to dig deep. In 3, in 2. Hold it right there. We'll do the other leg in a second. But we're about to go back to the zigzag. So do you need to make adjustments with the band? If you want to make it super hard, stand on the band and then try and do the zigzag. You'll be like this. All right? Or you can go to a purple. Okay, guys, we're going back to a zigzag. Doesn't matter, 2 or 4 steps forward and back. Ready? Come down low. Go. 1. That's it. So you see, I'm staying down in a little semi-squat here. So it's starting to starve the muscle of oxygen by keeping that contraction on. So always remember, the higher the band is up the leg, the easier it's going to be. So if you're starting to get fried and you're starting to hit failure, just move the band up about 1 inch above the knees. If it's still too much, lose the band, right? 4, 3, 2. Let's see, Jessica. All right, we're going to the other leg, guys. So you may want to adjust the band. If it's too much, maybe bring the band up to the top. Up here, all right? You're on the other leg. Ready? Drawn and strong. As low as you can, and then keep that chest up. You want to feel powerful contraction into the glutes. So we're not doing an arabesque, right? An arabesque is like this, but we don't want to do that. We want to keep that body tall, so as it comes up, it's a super powerful contraction. next time. And then we're moving on again, all right? So up to you guys. Like I said, you want to make it harder, stand on the band. Even harder, grab a dumbbell so you have additional resistance to work against. All right, guys, ready? 5, 6, 7. As wide as you can. Hey, if you snap the band, it's okay. Lifetime will give you another band to play with. It is all good. You will not be in trouble, all right? As wide as you can. So remember, our brain is going to keep us in that comfort zone, right? Your brain is going to go, I think this is enough, right? Tell your brain to take a seat and really see what happens if you step just a little wider. Yeah, yeah. 4. Got a Charlie horse for the girl. Charlie horse is the worst. All right there, guys. All we're going to do is a stagger to a hip extension. 5 on each side. Full range of movement. Shoulders up, back and down. Ready? Go. Down. That's it. So we want to squeeze the shoulder blades together, keep that chest lifted, so everything isolates the glutes. One more time. Can you take that to the other side? Other heel comes up. There. So imagine pulling your navel to touch the spine. I know that band, it looks so innocent. It is horrible, right? And that's what you guys. Beautiful. Can you believe it? You've already made it now, guys, to the AMRAPs, okay? So we're already on superset number 4 of 6. As I said, you're flying through this. Patrick will be happy today. So with the AMRAPs, to me, this is the hardest part of the whole workout. You're okay to lose the band if you like. The reason is, we're in it for a minute. You've only been doing 30 seconds to now. So now it's double the duration, all right? So this is a 6-minute block, guys. So the first one, I want you to go as heavy as you can handle, but it's a little bit funky. We're actually gonna hold the weight like this, okay? So what you're gonna do is you're gonna take it to a real lunge, and when you're down, you're gonna take a rotation. It's gonna throw you right off balance. Then you're gonna step in, 2 pulse squats. We're going to go back with that same leg so that we get used to the balance on that one leg. So what's going to happen, guys, is as you rotate, you're going to feel like you're going to fall over. So you need to push into that heel as hard as you can, and the leg is automatically going to contract. That's a protective reflex. So once you've got it, you want to take it as wide as you can, and then into 2 pulse squats. So 30 seconds on each leg. The next one. Oh, yay, more deficits, more rear lunges. I'm going to give you an option here, guys. If you want to do a box jump, just make sure the risers are on the end and your belt box is secure. A box jump, you're going to use the arm, you're going to jump up, but before you dismount, you've got 2 rear lunges, and you can either step off or jump off. If you don't want to jump, you can step up and do 2 tap backs, or you can just stay on the floor, right? Just do a squat and 2 alternating lunges. So you've got 3 levels to choose from. You're in for a minute. You think you're gonna handle it? All right, guys, so we're gonna start with a big heavy dumbbell. I'm gonna say somewhere between 12 and 20. All right. We're gonna start, maybe we all just start working on the left leg only. Ready? And let's go. So slow back, rotate. When you come to the center, 2 pulse lunges. Then back on the same leg. So I want to keep you on that same leg so you can start to get that motor coordination, that mind body. I love that with the body bar. That looks beautiful. Very nice. You got it, guys. Keep it going. In 4, 3. We're going to take that to the other leg, guys. Ready? And let's go. It's back. Rotate. How low can you come with those pulses? And again, same leg. So let's think about our alignment. Do you see how my legs are hip width apart, right? Driving into that front heel to keep you balanced. The abdominals are pulled in tight and that chest stays lifted. To make it hard, guys, rotate as much as you can. You got it. 4, 3, 2, and with that weight down, well done. You make that look easy. Now you've got that choice of a box jump and two lunges, or a step up with two tap backs. If you're doing a step, you can maybe do it with a dumbbell or barbell, or on the floor. All right, guys? 1 full minute though. Let's see what we got. 4, 3, 2, let's go. So we jump and then we lunge back on each leg, a deficit lunge, and then step or jump off the edge. So you're using the arms to power on up. You're trying to bring that back knee down towards the floor. So if that doesn't work for you, you can just do a step up and a tap back. You can do the step up with a barbell or a dumbbell like this. You can step up and you can tap back and back, right? By the same token, you can stay on the floor. You can do a squat. This is actually called a gorilla squat. The modification on the floor is a gorilla. Yeah, you guys, keep it going. This one's tough. You have got 15 seconds to go, and that would have been a minute. Can you do it? That's it. Listen to your body. Give yourself permission to pull back at any time. Beautiful. In 4, in 3, in 2. Super, you guys. Pull back, pull back. Woo! How about we take a little break here and just let you have a drink and just woo, see how you feel. All right. How would you get on with that rear lunge? So if you were really, really honest with yourself, could you go up 2 or 2.5 pounds with that dumbbell? That's up to you, right? So guys, again, whenever I create exercises to throw you off balance, it's because your muscles work twice as hard to stop you falling over. So there is a method in my madness, all right? Ding, ding, we're going back into round 2. This is gonna be the rear lunge with a rotation and 2 lower range squats. You think you can do it? All right, guys, we're gonna pick up that weapon. Get ready. 4, 3, 2, here we go. So it's here. How about I teach you, guys? And then low. Now if your legs are getting absolutely fried, you can limit that range of movement and maybe stay up in the upper range with that squat. Looks great for those body bars, guys. I love it. When you bring your knowledge into the studio, share it with your team members. It looks amazing. It looks amazing. Woo! You got this. In 4, 3. I'll go to the next count, right? All right there, guys. You're going to go ahead. Set it up on the other side. Ready. 5, 6, 7. Back. Big rotation. And all the way into the heels. So you don't necessarily have to fly through, right? Don't be afraid to take that. It is tough, guys. Glutius max out is a tough workout. In 5, 4, 3, 2, and hold. So now we're going back to the, maybe you've got 3 options. The box jump, lunges, the step up with the weight with a tap back, or the gorilla squat on the floor. Or you can mix and match, right? When you get tired, come down from the box. Get ready. 5, 6, 7, let's go. 2 deficits. That is hard. And then you can step or jump off. So if you're doing the box jump, guys, you really want to think about using the arms to power up, right? So think about down to get up. As you jump up, do your best to have that foot come dead center of the bench, right? Because if the heel hangs off the end and you jump up with all that power, you're gonna hurt your Achilles tendon, right? Woo! 4. Oh no, keep going. Sorry, you're 30 seconds in. 30 seconds in, you've got 30 seconds to go. Oh, that was mean. All right, so again, your other modification, if you're starting to get winded, is to pick up that weight, do a step up, and 2 anterior lunge back. Otherwise, you can take it into your gorilla squat. In 5, 4, 3, 2, woo, and pull back, guys. So once again, I'm going give you a tiny little break. So if you want to go ahead, have a little drink or whatever you have to do so that you can push really hard. So if you've got the right weight and you guys are working fearlessly, this last round should feel a little bit intimidating to you. You should be sitting there thinking, I'm not sure if I can do that again, all right? So if that's what you're thinking, you're in the right place, okay? You're doing great. So we've got one more round to go with that rotational rear lunge with those double squats. All right, after this, you've got one more superset, the max out, and then we're down on the floor with the hip thrusters. All right, guys, so we're over the hump and we're on our way home. All right, let's pick up that heavy weapon. With your left leg, I know, right? You're a little bit nervous now, right? And it's okay. Here we go. We take it in, big rotation, and then sit back into that invisible chair. Absolutely. Scorching those muscles, right? In. Needless to say, as you do the rotation, you are firing up the internal and external obliques. So you get a little bonus round by adding the abs. And exactly the same is happening with the body bars too. You're taking it into the obliques. Very, very nice, you guys. Woo! In four, in three. Guys, we're gonna take that to the other side. Ready? Set it up. 5, 6, 7. Back. Rotate. Now, how about this? As we take it back into that lunge, how about we rotate even further back? Yeah. So let's push the envelope, guys. Let's see what your body can take until you get to that point where you're like, oh, no, I think I'm going to fall over if I go further, right? So always keep pushing the envelope. You will be amazed at how strong you truly are. Every time we underestimate our own awesomeness, you've got to believe in yourself, right? Woo! In four, three, and two. Well done, guys. All right, your final one. If you are winded, take the low impact modification either on the bench or the gorilla squat. All right, if it's low impact, pick up the weight if you can. All right, 1 minute on the clock, and then we'll be moving on. Ready? 5, 6, 7. So you want to try and land center. Now, another good habit to get into is to try and land quietly like a cat. It's not that I mind about the noise. It's noisy enough in here, right? But the quieter you can land, the more control. Now, the more power you have jumping up, as you land in that box jump, it will push your butt all the way down, right? That's what you're looking for. So think of the cat landing on the roof. That's it. Beautiful. Beautiful weather windows. Looks great. Guys, you've got 20 seconds to go, and then you're done with these. So with that in mind, what have you got left inside of you, right? Think about your motivation. Think about your why. Here's your last 10 seconds. You look amazing. Very proud of you guys. In four, in three, in two. Woo! And have yourself a little break. Can you believe it? It's almost 5 o'clock already. All right, that's how hard you guys have been working. Now, this next one looks really innocent, but you're probably gonna be feeling your hamstrings for the next 48 hours after this exercise, and you'll be cursing me through to the weekend, right? Then I know my job here is done. So you can either hold the weight like, you're probably better holding like this, but if that's uncomfortable for you and you wanna do it here, that's fine. Now, all you're gonna do, guys, is once again, pulse squats, yay. 1, 2, 3, and then try and straighten the legs. It is gonna bite hard in the hamstrings. Now I don't lock out the knees. I wanna keep a little bend in the knees. Again, that activates the hamstrings. It hurts, it's hard. You wanna make it harder? Let me see if you can put a band on. Now probably don't put a band on because the next one, guys, you're gonna be doing that one for 45 seconds. The next one is a side lunge. We did that earlier, right? Toe forward. You're gonna come all the way down, step together, keep the hips and shoulders forward, and into a curtsy. Now, if you have any kind of cruciate ligament injury, you can't do a curtsy, just take it, yay, or rear lunges. You can take it to a rear lunge again, all right? So all you're gonna have is 25 seconds on each side. But we're gonna start with what I call the hinge squat. Do you want to try it once, just to make sure you got it right? Wait, you want to go heavy. You can also use a kettlebell if you want, guys. So first, just come low with three, low as you can, two, and now, stick the butt back and almost straight leg. You feel that in the hamstring? All right, guys, so we're gonna go for 45 seconds. Get ready. 5, 6, 7, down. And push back, ow. Right? I told you, sexy sculpted hamstrings. But you guys will be cursing me out for the next 48 hours. Wanna keep the head above the level of the heart. Your back is super vulnerable here, guys. Pull that navel all the way to the spine. Down in the heels. So it's like you're driving into the heels, you're driving the butt back, and you're feeling that big grab. 4, 3, 2, woo! All right there, how's that one, right? Can you stay with that heavy weight? Side lunge to a curtsy or side lunge to a rear lunge. 25 seconds. Ready, guys? Toes forward, here we go. Down. And curtsy.
Then we'll go with a kettlebell for 3 minutes.
the barbell for 3 minutes and we're done. Does that kind of help? Make you feel better? All right. They're like somewhat. Okay, guys, last time with those hinge squats, okay? If you want to do it without a weight, if you're fried, lose the weight, right? It's okay. So last 45 seconds with this puppy. In 4, 3, 2, here we go. 1, 2, 3, drive. So push down into the heels. When you do that squat, you should be able to move the toes a little bit so that you know that you haven't offloaded onto the knees or the ball of the feet. The reason I say that is when you get tired, your mind is always looking for an easy exit. So subconsciously, it's going to start to change the way that you do the squat to try and make it easier. So that's why I want you to use the mirrors and stay very, very self-aware. You got it, guys. 5, 4, 3, 2, and hold right there, super. Last time, 25 seconds each time. Side lunge to curtsy or side lunge to rear, with or without the weights, guys. Ready? Not really? 5, 6, 7. Low as you can, this is it, guys. And then curtsy. You got it. So as wide as you can. We still want to think about keeping that spine in a neutral alignment. You've got 10 more seconds on this side, guys. Lovely. Very, very nice. It's good to see that none of you are leaning over the ligament. In 4, in 3, in 2. All right, guys, we're going to take that to the other side. Ready? And let's go. Down. Now, this is your last 25 seconds here, right? So how about we go even wider, see where that sticking point is for you. What is your limit today? You got it. You've got 10 more seconds. Then we're moving on to our signature, the max out. In 5, in 4, in 3, and hold right there. Well done, guys. So the max out today, we're gonna be using a kettlebell. All right, now I'm gonna give you a choice of two. We do it 4 times, 8 times, 12 times, 16 and 20. It's just swings. So if you wanna stay low impact, all you're gonna do, drive back and swing. The feet will stay on the floor. If you want more, as that kettlebell comes up, you'll jump the feet together. That is super hard. Ideally, that's what you wanna go for, but if you're just fried and you can't, don't do it, all right? My advanced people, maybe you can go up to 15 or 20. If you're brand new, maybe 5 or 10. All right, guys, I'm gonna do it with you, all right? We're just gonna start with 4, then 8, then 12, all right? And then we'll check in before we go to 16 and 20 in case you need to change. High or low impact, driving back first. 5, 6, 7, drive, 1, 2, 3, and hold right there. How's that weight for you? Okay, let's go for 8. Ready, go, drive, 1, 2, that's it, guys. When the forearms touch the other side, that's your cue to drive it up. Woo! Hold it, that's 8. Now, if the jump is too high, I'll just sort of swing this time. barbell. If you don't want to use a barbell, you can place a heavy dumbbell on your hips. Now, if you bruise easily around the hips, guys, maybe you want to wrap a towel or two around the bar, or you can even wrap a mat around the bar. Now, what we're going to do is take a band around the thighs. So 1 inch above the thighs, guys. Now, when we're in a glute bridge position, we will be working the abdominals, the glutes, and the hamstrings. And then we're gonna make it even harder by adding that dumbbell. So I'm gonna show you what we're gonna do with that dumbbell, barbell. So, when you're in the glute bridge, guys, you wanna bring the heels close to the butt, the toes are up to the ceiling. So once you're here, you straight away are engaging the glutes and the hamstrings and the abdominals. Now, we're gonna carefully take that bar onto the hips. So the toes are up, it's gonna look like this, guys. Thrust up, abduct out and in, and down. That's round one. The second exercise, you will drive up, try and extend the leg, and lower down. So you will stay on the same leg for 15 seconds, all right, guys? So if the bar doesn't work for you, you wanna get a dumbbell, that's fine. I'm just gonna turn the music up. So you want the band on, bring in the barbell onto the hips. All right, guys. Let's go with a hip thrust and abduction. 3 minutes and we are done. Ready, 5, 6, 7. Up, out, in, down. Up, drive. So by keeping the heels close to the butt and the toes up to the ceiling, you are activating the glutes. In, out, in, down. And you wanna try and get the legs out as wide as you can. Keep it going, guys. That's it. In 4, in 3. All right, guys, now what we're gonna do is do a hip thrust and a leg extension. One leg only for 15 seconds. Here we go. Up, extend, and down. Keep the hips up, and then lower them down. Drive up. Woo! Do you feel how hard that foot, that leg that's got the foot on the ground, is working to hold the balance? Guys, take it to the other leg. So by keeping that toes off the floor, you have to take the entire weight of your body and that barbell into that hamstring in that stabilizing leg. One more. And release. Woo! Guys, we're gonna go back in. Hip thrust with an abduction. 2 minutes left. Heels up, toes up, sorry. Up, out, in, down. Now what I want you to do is as you take the legs out and in, squeeze, squeeze, squeeze into the glutes and feel the abs contract. Okay, take it up, out. You got it, keep it going. Lovely. In 4, in 3. This time we're gonna do that single leg extension, okay? So keep that heel down, ready, and let's go. Up, extend. So the reason I took my equipment off me is because I want you to see exactly what my body is doing. All right, so I'm driving down into the heel. When I do that extension, everything is transferred to that hamstring and that glute on that supporting leg. That's it, guys. Can you take it to the other side? Let's go. That's it. So you really want to focus on pushing as hard as you can into that heel. That's it. And get that extension. So you're unilaterally loaded. So again, because you're bringing one leg up, guys, that's also bringing in your obliques. Looks good. In 4, in 3, in 2. Beautiful. This is your last minute, guys. Last time with the up and abduction. Ready, and let's go. Up as wide as you can. Don't be afraid to explore how far out you can take those legs, guys. So we're sculpting the inner and outer thighs. I'm working on gluteus medius and minimus, working on that little dancer's indentation just up high on the thigh. You got it, guys. In 5, 4, we are coming up to our final 30 seconds. Ready, one leg at a time, and let's go. Up, extend, in. All right, guys, we're gonna take that to the other leg for your final 15 seconds. Up, drive, beautiful. Looks so good. That's it. In five, in four, in three, in two. And guys, hold right there. Let's carefully go ahead and take your time getting that bar off of you. Let's go ahead, remove that band. Spend a couple of seconds cooling you down. If you've got any juice left, Patrick will be in here with barbell strength. You guys were awesome tonight. Let's go ahead, take it up, and flex the point. There we go. Now, there should be no pain. We hit those hamstrings hard, guys. Pull the leg in a little bit closer to that point of general tension. Let's drop the foot down to the opposite knee. Reach forward, take hold of the thigh. Keep pulling it in till you feel that release in the hip. We're going to take that top knee, let it fall to the floor, hand in the opposite direction. It feels good, especially after all those swings, right? You did those lunges with a rotation. Now the hamstring on the other side, guys. Take it up and take it up. Flex a point, wait for the muscle to relax. So you did the good mornings, the Romanian deadlifts, you did those hinge squats. And pull it just a little bit closer. Let's go ahead, drop that foot down to the opposite side. Reach forward, take hold of the thigh. Keep pulling in and feel that release. Yeah, taking that top knee down to the floor and in the other direction. Alright, let's stretch out those poor quads. Man, we were those today. So we got a straight line from the ear to the shoulder to the hip to the heel. Press that foot as hard as you can into the hand. At the same time, you want to tilt the pelvis forward. Yeah. Take it on up and cross over. Ever so gently, you want to just push that thigh away. You're feeling the stretch in the medials right here. We're going to take that bottom leg underneath us. Again, we're just going to get our alignment. Correct alignment means a more effective stretch. Keep pushing that foot hard into the hand. And let's just come on up. And gently push it away. We did lots of side lunges. We did those curtsies. And of course, we did the back work earlier with the zigzags. Now we're just going to go ahead and sit back onto the heels, take the hips back on the heels, and just keep walking the fingers away, guys. You just did all those kettlebell swings. Now for the hip flexors, we did a lot of lunges today. We're just going to come up, take one leg forward, and let that pelvis come here. Take the arm across. Yeah. Yeah. To the other side, guys. This little muscle that crosses the hip joint, the ASAS, does a lot of work during those lunges. One more, guys. You're just going to come up, and as you drop, you're going to feel that stretch in that hamstring, as well as in the obliques and the lats. To the other side. You guys were phenomenal this evening. I'm proud of you.